spirit for a reason. My brothers and my sisters, it behooves you, and it behooves me to find out what that purpose and that reason is. You're here because God has a plan and design for your life, and He's given you certain abilities to cause that thing to manifest. He's given you a certain swag. He's given you a certain persuasion and a certain influence and a certain talent to bring about ultimately the design, the plan He has for your life. So not only do we pray, not only do we praise, but we play. That means we use the instruments and use the ability that God has given to us to advance the kingdom. Are y'all hearing me on today? Come here, let me ask you a question. What are your gifts? What are your talents? What are your natural abilities? How has God uniquely crafted you? And how are you using that to advance the kingdom? What role are you playing in your place of worship? And what area in the community are you using your giftedness, your sway, your swag, your influence? There's a church that needs your administrative skills. There's a church that needs your technological advanced insight. There's a church that can use your voice. There's a church that can use your giftedness and instruments. There's a church that can use you in hospitality. There's a church that can use you in going out and ministering to the community. There's a church that can use you to go behind the prison walls and minister to those who are incarcerated. There's a church that can use you in the bereavement ministry. There's an area for you to serve in. Let me ask you a question. How are you using your giftedness? How are you using your sway, your persuasion, your swag to advance the kingdom's agenda? Shame on any person who does not use what God has given to them for God. You have a voice of influence. You have writing ability. You have poetic expression. You are gifted in dance. You are gifted in working with young people. You're gifted in working with seniors. You're gifted in working with those who are addicted to drugs and what have you. How are you using your giftedness? In your profession, you go and you clock in. You certain hours, you work a certain amount of hours every day and every week, and you help to advance corporate America. You help to advance the city and all the government or private industries. What are you going to use your giftedness for the kingdom? They pray. They praise. And they play. If they're playing their instruments, it was them using what God had given to them. God has given you something, my brothers and my sisters. Watch this. And it was in this milieu, this environment, where my God showed up and He showed out. Listen, He guaranteed victory to them because they first of all prayed, praised, and played. God honored their commitment to Him. So therefore, He made a commitment to them. And they came out on the other side. And they came out on top. And what I'm suggesting to you is that if you want to come out on the other side, if you want to come out as the victor and not the victim, if you want to come out and be victorious, I admonish you to do the same thing they did. Pray, praise, and play. Because it is in that environment that God shows up and shows out, and He showed Himself to be mighty. Y'all, they couldn't do it on their own. That was evident. It was obvious. They couldn't do it on their own. They needed God in the equation. I want to suggest to you that you can't do it on your own. You've tried it your way, now try it God's way. I want to suggest to you, my brothers and my sisters, that just when you think that you have run out of all your possibilities, that is when God shows His greatest ability. Yes. Listen, when you watch this, when man's greatest extremity is God's greatest opportunity. When you've reached the max, when you've exhausted your finances, and you've exhausted all your resources, and you've exhausted all your options, that's when God shows up and shows Himself to be large. And in charge. Wow.
Thank you.
This place to be reminded that you are the great God of all.